Speaking of pot, down in Florida, medical marijuana was on the ballot, and it got a majority of the vote, but it didn't hit that 60% threshold necessary to pass. What's your take on that, and how did it fail?
Well, I looked at it this from a different way. What the Republicans took the Sheldon Adelson money, $3 million that was used to try to defeat amendment to the legalized pot amendment, and they used it to scare Republicans to death. They tried to use it to scare elderly. To talk about things, medical marijuana is going to bring crime to the streets. We're going to have drug bosses running our state. Those are the types of things that they heard. It was scare tactics. So that was initially put out there because the thought was it's going to bring young people to vote, and it did. But if you look at how it energized kind of the elderly part of the GOP, which is for the most part all old, but it even took it took them, it energized them, it scared them, and unfortunately, in the end, it probably worked against the Democrats. You know, the truth is, in Florida, they're making inroads to legalized marijuana. There's Charlotte's Web, which is a great step towards legalized marijuana for children suffering from epilepsy. It's the first step. Now the question becomes: is this 58% that passed that wanted legalized marijuana in Florida, is that enough for this legislature to say, you know, maybe we ought to take Charlotte's Web and even expand on that? But Charlotte's Web is a very important first step towards trying to say we can treat people with a little more compassion by legalizing parts of marijuana.
Now, Charlotte's Web is the oil that is made from pot plants that are hybridized to have high levels of the don't get you high stuff, but it's therapeutic, and very low levels of the get you high stuff. Is that available in Florida?
It will be. Legislature has already passed it. Right now, the Rules Committee is writing this up. Tom, this is an extraordinary thing. Children who are having 30 to 50 grand mal seizures a day, it abates it to the tune of 95%. It is extraordinary. They've had great success with it in Colorado. Now it's here in Florida. And my point being, this message to legislature, which is 58% of the Florida public voted and said, yes, we want legalized marijuana. Hopefully they'll expand on what they've already enacted, which is the Charlotte's Web legislation. Charlotte's Web is basically the Coca-Cola brand, I guess, if you will, of legalized marijuana, medical marijuana. And so I think it's a good first step. I think it's an important movement in Florida. And I think we'll continue seeing progress there.